The Batman.
Yes, the new one.
The new Robert Pattinson Batman film.
That movie slaps.
Why don't we just do a little group discussion here? Because we both, you and I both watched two Batman films this weekend, or last
both
weekend.
Both great.
Both fantastic.
In their own way.
Yeah, and the first was, to prep ourselves for the second, we watched Batman and Robin.
Yeah. So totally nowhere near where the other one is. But yeah, so the original, or, you know, whatever, that Batman and Robin movie, which was Joel Schumacher, right?
Yeah.
One of the two that he did. And I'm here to tell you, my man, that movie is a fucking a lot of fun, dude. That movie gets a really bad rap, but my man, it is so entertaining.
That movie slaps.
It's so good, man. It's so good. It has like a 1-something on Letterboxd. I don't know what people are watching, but if you don't watch that movie and you're like, damn, that was a good time, then you must hate movies and humanity, because that movie slaps.
Yeah, that movie's really fun, and it's funny, and it's ridiculous, and the thing is, I think people take it seriously, and okay, that's why they say it's bad.
You can't do
how?
That.
How can you take it seriously? How can you look at that film and say, oh yeah, they were being very serious when they made this?
Listen to one of Arnold Schwarzenegger's like 40 puns that he makes, dude. Come on, man.
Also, the bat nipples, I found out, did not originate in that film. They actually originated in like 2 films before that.
Wow.
So not even their idea.
Well, I'm a fan of them. And also, of course, the goat, the bat credit card, dude.
The bat credit card, the rubber lips.
The rubber lips. What a good meme, dude.
Yeah, there's a lot of good things in that movie. We mentioned very theatrical. The set pieces are very weird and like almost like a stage show.
Yeah, it feels like watching like a live stage show, like a ridiculous stage show.
Yeah. There was some really bad CGI. There was some really bad practical effects. A lot of like zoom ins on batarangs. Mm-hmm. And grapple hooks, like whenever someone will use a grapple hook, it would like zoom in on their grapple hook for some reason and like show the logo.
Yeah.
But I had a great time. And then after we watched that, we went immediately to the theater to see The Batman.
Yes. The new one.
The new Robert Pattinson Batman film.
Yeah. And I'm also here to tell you that that movie slaps.
Yeah. That movie's really good. I had a really good time with that one. It was literally a detective movie, a buddy cop movie, a superhero movie. But I want to emphasize, though, it may be a superhero movie, but I was talking to someone at work and I said it would be very strange if they continued this franchise. This is the Batman franchise, and introduced a supervillain that had like a superpower, or like if Superman were to appear, right, it would be very strange because this film is so grounded in reality.
Right. It is. You're right. And I think that that's fine. If they're going to make more in this universe, which by all accounts, they probably are, because this movie crushed at the box office.
There's spinoff shows already announced.
Yeah. If you keep it contained like this and focus on that detective element and like the psychological stuff and, you know, Batman versus all of these different villains, and then they introduced somebody at the end of the first movie that, of course, people would be excited about. Like, I think you could keep it really self-contained and grounded. And I mean, the detective elements, right, are some of the most interesting parts of the movies. The detective elements and the character exploration with different stuff.
Yeah.
And one thing that really stood out to me, more than a movie has in a really long time, was the music. Like, this is one of Michael Giacchino's best scores, and this man did The Incredibles and shit. Like,
he only did 2 songs in this as well.
Really?
Yeah, he only did a couple songs, like 1 or 2.
Well,
but but that theme slaps.
The creation of that theme and how it's used throughout. Mm-hmm.
And I sent you a TikTok that speculates that it's that Nirvana. There's a Nirvana song in the movie as well.
Right.
And there's a TikTok that speculates that he was very much inspired by that TikTok, or I'm sorry, that Nirvana song.
Yeah.
If you slow that song down and you break it down into its chords,
yeah,
that is the Batman theme that he created. So, very cool.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun with it. By the way, I didn't get a chance to talk to you about this. I did watch a little bit of a Matt Reeves interview where he talks about the film.
Oh, yeah.
And he mentions that that character in the jail cell, who is a villain of Batman, it is who you think it is. Mm-hmm. And he's in there because he's already had his first encounter with Batman before.
Good.
So they've already met. They've already have a history there. Very not good situation.
That's
so,
good. Which is one of the really refreshing things about this movie, too. So hopefully they'll continue that in the future. Is like they don't retread this mm-hmm. same crap we've seen 1,000 times.
Not he's
crap,
only been Batman for 2 years.
You know what I mean? Like they skipped the origin story, right? And he's Batman.
It kind of is almost the origin story. They just skipped the boring parts.
They skipped the parts that we've seen 1,000 times.
Yeah.
Essentially.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's cool because the dynamic there between Batman and this other character is always like you're the same thing. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So, yeah, I'm excited for more, especially if Matt Reeves is involved.
Yeah, man.
So
he knows like he had a vision and he knew what he wanted and he executed on it.
Yeah,
I think that's really cool.
And props to WB for apparently not meddling at all and just allowing him to do whatever he wanted because it paid off.
Yeah, there's a Penguin spinoff show coming out, which mm-hmm. him and Colin Farrell are executive producing, which is really cool.
Yeah.
And then there was a canceled Gotham Police show, which I would have loved. But
that would have been really cool. Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe to Haptic Intel. Did you do it? Subscribe right now.